Well, my friends, after countless people begged car makers to bring back the small pickup, well, they're back. Not that long ago, we drove the Hyundai Santa Cruz. This is its nearest competitor. This is the all-new Ford Maverick. Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now, why are we driving a Ford Maverick? Well, it's one of the hottest new products you can get for 2022. I mean, small pickups have been absent from the North American market for a really long time. And now they're finally here. We drove the Santa Cruz from Hyundai a little while ago, and now we've got our hands on this Ford Maverick. So let's have a look at this in a little more depth. If you're not familiar with Maverick, what you need to know straight away is that it's related to the Escape and the Bronco Sport, and that means a lot of things and a lot of good things as we will get into. However, this is a full jam Lariat that's all-wheel drive with the 2-liter turbo. This is not the hybrid model, the one that gets crazy mileage that everybody seems to be talking about. No, this is the desirable one as far as I'm concerned. So let's have a look at the specification. The engine's the 2-liter 4-cylinder EcoBoost. Here it makes 250 horsepower at 5,500 RPM and 277 pounds of torque at 3,000 RPM. The transmission is an 8-speed automatic, not a CVT like the hybrid, and like I mentioned, this is all-wheel drive. As you'd expect for a small truck in 2022, the chassis is a unibody. Suspension is based around McPherson struts in the front, multi-link in the rear, and of course, this is an inexpensive truck, so it's got conventional dampers. Steering is electrically assisted, brakes are 4-wheel discs, of course, and since this is the FX4 Lariat, it's on 17s. Inside, there's some underseat storage in the back, which is pretty cool. On the outside, the one thing you do need to know about the bed is that it does have some flexibility for hauling things, tying things down, and this one is the top spec model, so it's got a power outlet in the back. The great thing for short blokes like me is that this is a little truck and I can actually step up into the bed. How do you like that? I love it. Anyway, what you do want to know is payload. That's 1,500 pounds. Basic towing capacity is 2,000 pounds, but because this is the 2-liter turbo with all-wheel drive, it will tow up to 4,000 pounds. Curb weight of the Maverick is 3,700 pounds. It's that time in the episode for how to spec your Ford Maverick. Base price in the United States is $26,575. In Canada, it's $34,450. And that's for a fairly basic Maverick. Given that this has every available factory option, certainly doesn't have any dealer installed accessories as tested, this is $37,545 US. In Canada, it's $40,730. Now, how do you spec yours? Well, given that I've been enjoying it like this, as we will discuss a little further, the only thing I would do is give it a wash, but no, I would paint it in a bold color. Equip it just the same. Get every option on this thing because it's so distinctive, it's so interesting. Everybody wants to talk about it. You might as well make it interesting and put a bold color on this Maverick. Of course, on this channel, we're always concerned about how we interface with a vehicle, and it's just about perfection here. That has to do with Ford's understanding of ergonomics and how they do things inside, but the basics are quite right. The seat is just about perfect, that the hip height is spot on. There's lots of adjustment in the steering column as well. So I'm well set up here to interface with the vehicle. There's a nice dead pedal on the left for my left foot. My relationship to the pedals is just about perfect as well. The only thing I would like is maybe a little bit more support out of the seat. I mean, we are talking about an inexpensive small truck, so I can appreciate why we don't have a big seat in here, but maybe that's my only complaint about the seating position. In terms of visibility, it's just simply excellent. You're set up perfectly here. Forward, rearward visibility is top notch. And of course, there is a backup camera to help you with parking. The ergonomics are very much Ford. They're very simple, very straightforward, nothing confusing, very easy to interface with. And if you're new to Ford, there's not much of a learning curve to get used to this either. The infotainment system is modern Ford. It's not as advanced as what we saw in the big Bronco a little while ago, but it is straightforward enough. It does have Apple CarPlay. It might have Android Auto, but I really don't care. Spaciousness in the front row, no issue at all. Very comfortable for you and your passenger in here. There's lots of room and there's plenty of storage. Lots of little things. There is wireless charging for your phone and lots of connections. There are various power outlets in this interior as well. But overall, it's a wonderful interior. I do want to talk about the interior design, and this is a winner. What they've done with textures and shapes and just the overall finish of this interior, especially for a truck that doesn't cost very much. This is just a brilliant interior. It's one of the best interiors I've seen in a really long time. The good thing about the second row is that there is some decent underseat storage. The bad thing is there's not much space for full-size humans. I can just fit behind myself in the seating position. Sure, I could make a little bit more room for a passenger in the back seat, but this is a small pickup truck, so don't expect a generous amount of room in that second row. With the 2-liter EcoBoost and the fact that this weighs 3,700 pounds, thankfully acceleration is a little bit more than modest. It's not a rocket ship by any stretch of the imagination, but because that 2-liter EcoBoost makes so much torque, it never has any trouble getting up to speed quickly, whether that's in town or on the freeway, and it's happy to cruise along. This 8-speed automatic seems to be paired perfectly with this engine. I'm really impressed at how the entire driveline is calibrated. It just works wonderfully here. The only thing I will say about the engine is that it makes some 4-cylinder wheezy noises from time to time. I suppose that could be an improvement Ford could make in the future to make it sound great, because you can make this engine sound pretty good, so why not? But this isn't the kind of truck that you buy because it's got a great sounding engine now, is it? As you can see in some of the shots, I was able to drive this in a little bit of snow, which was a good thing. And what I found is that torque transfer to the rear axle with this all-wheel drive system is almost instantaneous. It had tons of grip in a little bit of snow that I was able to drive in. And, you know, maybe with systems turned off, it could be a little fun. Who knows? I'd like to try this more in winter conditions. But overall, I was pretty impressed with that torque transfer to the rear axle. Very much instantaneous. Very impressive. Because this is a fully equipped Maverick, it does have some of Ford's advanced driver assist, so it does have adaptive cruise control and it does have lane keep assist, and they both work fairly well. I'm pretty happy with those. The steering is electrically assisted. It's fairly light, easy to maneuver when parking and that sort of thing, but there's not a lot of feel or feedback that comes from this. If you're trying to carve some corners, it is direct, works just fine, but otherwise it's just your standard fairly light electrically assisted steering system. Initial brake application is what you'd call touchy. I'm not quite sure why it does that, but it's one of the sharpest brake pedals I've experienced in a little while, at least on initial application. Once you're into the brake pedal, however, it's just fine. It's got modest feel, you've got decent control, and there's plenty of braking power with these brakes. No problem there. I'd like to see how this braking system works when you're towing 4,000 pounds, but maybe we'll save that for next summer when we tow a boat. What really paints a smile on my face about this Maverick is its overall dynamic package. The drivetrain is very well resolved, but that in combination with the way its handling works is just a wonderful combination. This is an exceptionally well-riding, well-handling small pickup, and that's what I really enjoy about it. It's so well resolved in that way. I'm just impressed with it, and I want to keep driving this thing. I really don't want to give it back to Ford. It is so much fun to drive. It's just the right size. It fits everywhere. And then, you know, it only weighs 3,700 pounds. It's got plenty of torque so that you can go quickly if you need to. But this is just an excellent dynamic package. Handling is very well balanced. The dampers have great body and wheel control. No, this isn't a sports car. This is car based naturally, but you've got excellent body and wheel control with the suspension setup. I'm very, very impressed with what Ford has done with this Maverick suspension. Blows my mind that they can make such a well riding and great handling little pickup, but they've done it with this Maverick. Overall, as you can tell, I'm very impressed with the Maverick, but here's the thing. It's not gonna work for every pickup owner. Here we are, there's a couple of F-150s at the side of the road here in wine country, and those do full-size pickup jobs. This is not gonna be capable of doing some of those jobs. It's limited to towing 4,000 pounds, 1,500 pounds payload. This isn't big enough for four full-size adults inside. So you've gotta take these things into consideration when you're looking at a small truck. However, there are plenty of people who are going to be perfectly satisfied with a small pickup like this Maverick. My verdict, well, some of you do want to know fuel consumption, and I'm the worst example because I have a heavy right foot. I'm enjoying all the power and the torque that the 2-liter EcoBoost makes. So as a result, I'm getting about 11 liters per 100 kilometers for my Canadian friends, or about 20 miles per gallon for you Americans out there. So your mileage will be better. Mine is bad simply because I've got a heavy foot. Don't take this as gospel. Your mileage will absolutely be better. As for the Maverick, well, who knew that in 2022, Ford could turn out such a good product? And they did it the right way. They took existing tech from the Escape and the Bronco Sport and repurposed it into a properly well-resolved small pickup truck. I love the way it drives. I love its dynamics. I love the form factor. And in fact, there's very little that I don't like. I even like the way it looks. It's such a distinctive small pickup truck, and I'm getting all kinds of attention everywhere I go with this thing. It's very, very interesting. Who knew that people would be interested in a small pickup truck from Ford? And indeed they are, and for good reason. I love this little pickup truck, and I can't spend enough time with it.